danger. A fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty Hi-Yo Silver. The Lone Ranger. This is a story of one of the most mysterious characters to appear in the early days of the West. He was a fabulous individual, a man whose presence brought fear to the lawless and hope to those who wanted to make this frontier land their home. He was known as the Lone Ranger. Before his coming, this new land of the West was a wild, unruly territory into which brave American pioneers moved in covered wagons, on horseback, and afoot. Theirs was a rugged existence, for they not only had to settle and build, they had to fight. Here, beyond the reach of law and order, might was right. The best shot was the best man. Born of necessity in this chaotic period of westward expansion, an organization was developed to combat the evil forces of the times. An organization called the Texas Rangers. Ever on the job of maintaining law and order, six Texas Rangers ride alertly across a western landscape. All are courageous, straight-shooting men. At their head is a stranger, a half-breed scout, who one day earlier had appeared at a ranger encampment, suffering from a severe wound.
There you are, Collins. Nothing to worry about now.
Thanks, Captain. I should worry about a wound. I'm lucky to be alive.
You're right. Very few people are after those outlaws have struck. So they killed everybody at the trading post.
Everyone. Mr. Simpson, his wife, the young Indian helper, even old Pete McHenry.
That's too bad.
How about the outlaws? Any of them get shot?
Four of them were in pretty bad shape. They had to be tied to their horses to ride away. I got two of them myself.
Too bad you couldn't hit more of them. Which way did they go?
They rode up north, into the Badlands.
That's pretty rough country. But with wounded men in tow, they can't travel very fast. We got a chance to catch them.
But they have a 5-hour start. Even if you overtook them, they outnumber you.
Mister, the Rangers are used to long odds. How about you? We could use your help in locating their trail if you feel strong enough to ride.
I don't need two arms to guide a horse. Besides, I have a score to even up to. I'll go along.
Good man. Boys, pack 5 days' rations. We've got 10 minutes to be in the saddle.
Right.
Bill, send Captain Reed to me. He's leading your detachment.
Yes, sir.
So came the half-breed Collins, who rides with a detachment of Rangers after the most ruthless outlaw band in the West, the notorious Cavendish Gang.
It's their trail, Reed.
Yeah.
And it indicates they're riding slowly as we figured.
Yes, it does.
Let's go, boys.
Gained on them. These tracks can't be more than 3 hours old.
They're heading off into that canyon.
Yeah, look that way. Have you been in this vicinity before?
A couple of times.
I think it might be a good idea for us to check that canyon from the rim first.
I'll go ahead and scout the place. One man would be a lot less noticeable than all of us going.
All right. We'll wait here and give the horses a rest.
Dismount, men.
Hold it, mister. Reach.
Hello, Whitey.
Oh, it's you. The new man, huh?
Yeah, it's me.
How's the plan going?
All right. The rangers are back at the canyon entrance.
You think they'll keep on coming?
Sure, why not?
They're pretty smart umbers, you know.
Yeah?
We've tried to get them before. Didn't pan out.
I wasn't with you then. Where's Cavendish?
He's up there a ways. Leave your horse here.
All right.
I knew they'd fall for my little trap, Collins. And that bullet I put in your arm really convinced them.
Yeah, Cavendish. It sure did.
When I get through around here, it's going to be a long time before any ranger outfit patrols in this section of the country. We're going to make this something they won't forget.
Is the ambush all set?
Take a gander over there. You know, my men could slaughter a whole army from up here.
It looks good to me.
Now, we're going to hold our fire until the lawmen ride in directly below us. Jerry, you tell the boys I'll shoot first. That'll be the signal to open up on the rangers.
Right.
And Jerry, when a man goes down, I want lead to be kept pouring into him till he looks like a sieve. You got that straight?
You bet. Come on, Blackie.
All right. Collins, you're doing a good job for a new man.
Thanks, Chief.
Now get back there and bring on the Texas Rangers.
Yeah, sure.
See anything?
Yes, but not on the rim. The Cavendish outfit is just leaving the far side of the canyon, about 4 miles off.
Are you sure?
I saw their dust.
Good. Here we go, men.
Must have taken a wrong turn. Look up there, it's a head wall. No passage through here. Say, where's Collins?
He was right behind us a while ago. I saw him.
Look! It's an ambush, men. Spread out and find cover, quick! That half-breed traitor Collins. Whoa.
Men down there. Make sure they're dead.
You got them all.
Good. Go on back to your horse. We'll wait for you up here.
Thought he was one of us, Chief.
He was. Any man who would betray those rangers might be just as quick to turn on us, I figured. And no one does that. It's gonna be a nice little reminder for anybody who tries to stop me from now on.
Yeah.
Now let's get out of here. Got a lot of work to do in Colby. Yeah.
Many hours after the Cavendish gang has left the ambush scene, a lone figure moves painfully over the rock-strewn ground. A small spring gurgling in a shady cave is his destination. He alone of the six Texas Rangers still lives. His one aim is to reach water and shade. Desperately, he fights off the weakness from loss of blood, which threatens to halt his progress. It is deathly hot. The sun beats down unmercifully. Ahead is that cooling, life-giving water. If his strength can only last. Foot by foot, sheer torture, he pulls himself along. There, out of the hot glare of the sun, only a short distance farther. There's the spring. Now his bandana. There. Cold water never felt better. Never seen sweeter than now. 100 yards away, Colin stirs, unaware of the existence of the spring and the ranger who lies beside it. He too, miraculously, has escaped a mortal wound from a Cavendish bullet. And he too, like the ranger, knows that death lurks in the hot rays of the sun. He must seek shelter somewhere, quickly, within the confines of the canyon. Weakly, he stumbles off to find shade, to nurse his wounds. Then, as if timed by fate, a third figure, an Indian, enters the hot canyon. Surprised, he sees the results of the Cavendish gang's handiwork. Texas Rangers, sprawled in attitudes of violent death. These were men to whom heroic deeds were a part of each day's work. And now their work was done. Then, by chance, the native spies the figure lying beside the distant pool. He moves forward.
Lie still. Mean not hurt you. Why, you Kimosabe.
Kimosabe? That sounds familiar.
That's right, Kimosabe. You trusty scout.
Trusty scout?
Yes, Ranger. Long time back, when we both young. Me remember time Indian camp burned. Renegade Indians raid settlement when men of tribe away. Kill my mother, my sisters. They leave me for dead. You found me, nursed me back to health, saved me from dying. When me well, you give me horse to go find my father. Me take horse only when you accept gift. My ring, it make good luck. Me call you Kimosabe. It mean trusty scout. Me never forget you. You remember now?
Yes. You're Tonto.
That's right. Me Tonto. Now me take care of you.
Immediately, the Indian, Tonto, unsaddles his horse and sets up a camp at the entrance of the cave near the pool and the injured man. The ranger's wounds are cleansed and expertly dressed by the Indian, who calls upon all the lore he knows to ease his white friend's suffering. Several days of patient vigil, tender care, and careful feeding bring results. The ranger gradually regains his strength. He is going to live.
Tonto, I guess I drifted off again. How long have I been here now?
3 days. How you feel?
Still a little weak. The other rangers, Tonto, all dead? One of them, Captain Reed, was my brother.
Too bad. Rangers all fine men.
We didn't have a chance, Tonto. It was a perfect ambush and double cross. How did you happen to find me?
Me hunt here in canyon often. Ride in here on scout over yonder. Find rangers and dead horse.
I see.
While you sleep, me bury other rangers over there. Make grave for men. Bring belongings here.
That was good of you, Tonto.
Them brave men.
Yes, they were brave. And they won't be forgotten. I've spent a lot of time thinking. For every one of those men, I'm going to bring 100 lawbreakers to justice. I'll make that Cavendish gang and every criminal that I can find, for that matter, regret the day those rangers were killed. Tonto, from this moment on, I'm going to devote my life to establishing law and order in this new frontier, to make the West a decent place to live.
That good. But when Cavendish gang know you escape ambush, you marked man. They hunt you down, many against one.
No one is going to know I'm alive. I'm supposed to be dead, and I'm going to stay that way. I'll hide my identity somehow. I'll wear a disguise of some sort.
You mean like mask?
That's it, Tonto. From now on, I'll wear a mask. Let's see. There ought to be some material here I can use. Here. This. My brother's vest. Belonged to one of the bravest of them all.
Me help Kimosabe. You rest now.
All right, Tonto. Thanks.
There, face wounds all healed now.
Let me have the mask. There. It fits perfectly. Good job, Tonto.
Here, hat. Me wash in stream, dry in sun, make whiter.
Thanks, Tonto.
Here, gun to kill bad men.
I'm not going to do any killing.
You not defend yourself?
Oh, I'll shoot if I have to. But I'll shoot the wound, not to kill. A man must die, it's up to the law to decide that. Not the person behind a six-shooter.
That's right, Kimosabe.
Well, there's just one more thing to be done.
What's that?
Dig another grave. Out there.
Who that's for?
That'll be my grave.
There. Just like others.
That's good. Only you, Tonto, know I'm alive. To the world, I'll be buried here. Beside my brother and my friends. Forever.
You all alone now. Last man. You are a Lone Ranger.
Yes, Tonto. I am a Lone Ranger.
Kimosabe, me help you fight outlaw.
But Tonto, don't you have a family? Anyone?
No. Me lone like you. Me want law here too. For all.
All right, Tonto. You'll be a lot of help. We'll ride together.
Me glad, Kimosabe. Me fight good for you.
Take cover, Tonto. That's Collins, the man that led us into ambush.
Why him shoot?
Undoubtedly, he's after your horse. Collins must have been deserted by the outlaws. He's probably been making his way to that vantage point for some time now.
Why him go there, Kimosabe?
He knows the only way to get scout is to kill us. He is well protected up there.
What we do now?
I'm going to keep him back under cover while you make a run for scout. Take Scout into the cave. Collins won't be able to see you from there.
Me do.
I'll follow Tonto as soon as you're safe. All right, run. Tonto, I didn't try. We're going to capture him alive.
That hard. Him in a good spot.
Yes, but I have an idea how we can do it. You start up the cliff on that side. First, tie up Scout. I'll try to draw his fire from the other side of the rocks.
Him dead, Kemosabe. But me glad. Him deserve to die.
No, Tonto. No one should have his life end like this.
Better him dead. Like white parson say, this act of providence. Now no one know you still live.
Yes, that is true. A strange act of providence has protected my secret.
Me dig grave for him.
All right. I'll get Scout ready for travel. Tonto?
Me ready. We go after the rest of Cavendish gang now?
As soon as we can. But I've got to get a mount of some sort. We'll head off toward Wild Horse Valley. Here, take Scout. Come on, boy.
For 2 days, the Lone Ranger and Tonto traveled toward the remote valley of Wild Horses, where a particularly sturdy breed of horses lives, unknown and unmolested by the hunters of the West. Later, at the entrance to this valley, the Lone Ranger and Tonto hear sounds of a furious battle. Beyond the rocks in a small glen, they catch a glimpse of a huge buffalo about to gore the life out of a fallen horse. Quickly, the Lone Ranger reaches for his gun.
You hit him, Kemosabe.
I hope it was soon enough, Tonto.
Thank you.
no dying. Horse look bad. Me shoot him?
No, Tonto. I'm going to try to pull him through. Well, old fellow, you're in bad shape. A lot of bumps and bruises. Tonto, get some rags from the supplies and bring the canteen.
Me do.
So, in an instant, the Lone Ranger has made a momentous decision, for he has recognized the sterling qualities of the animal he has saved. For some time, the masked man in the Indian camp beside the wounded horse, tending his battle hurts and caring for him as best they know how. Now, human hands have done all they can to help nature in healing the animal's wounds. Can the wild stallion rise? Gently, the masked man coaxes the horse.
Easy. Easy, big fellow. Come on your feet. Come on, boy. Come on, boy. Easy, big fellow. Easy.
Me get bridle and lariat. Him run away.
No. Wait, Tonto. I like that horse more than anything in the world. But if he wants to go, he should be free.
Him a beauty. Like mountain with snow. Silver white.
Silver. That would be a name for him. Here, Silver. Come back, big fellow. One, Silver. Come back, big fellow. Come on, Silver.
Me get bridle now. Him come back.
No, he wouldn't take a bit. I'll use a hackamore for the time being. Won't be as strange to his head as a bridle. There. There, Silver. If you only knew how we need you. Oh. Oh, boy. Oh. Oh. Oh, big fellow. Ready? We're going to do a lot of riding together. We're going to be pals, aren't we, Silver?
A few days later, after the horse has recovered his strength, the Lone Ranger tightens the saddle on the back of the white stallion. Quickly, the masked man mounts, and for the first time in his life, Silver bears weight upon his back. Soon, under expert and gentle guidance, the horse quiets and responds quickly to the Lone Ranger's lead. Later, the hackamore is exchanged for a bridle and bit. Here is no conflict between animal and master. Here instead is a partnership between horse and rider. The Lone Ranger and Silver accept each other as equals.
He's a beauty, Tonto. A dream horse if I ever rode one.
Him and Scout good friends.
Yes. They'll do a lot of riding, side by side.
Me got everything packed. Here's saddlebag. Here, blanket. We ride after Cavendish gang now?
Yes, Tonto. They were headed toward Colby. Then, too, there's an old-timer there I want to see by the name of Jim Blaine. All right, let's go. Jim Blaine's place.
Look like him got company.
We will wait until the caller leaves before we drop in.
It's nice seeing you, Judge.
Be seeing you next week, Jim.
Look, the side of the house. Come on.
Got him, Chief.
Good. But he winged me. Is he out?
Cold. He won't be seeing light for hours.
Trade guns.
Say, you're bleeding bad.
Yeah, I must have hit an artery. You get on the road pronto and spread the news. The shoot men get me a doc. I'll meet you at the Glen.
All right.
Someone's coming. We gotta clear out of here fast.
Him dead yonder, Kimosabe. How's Jim?
He's had a hard knock.
Me thought maybe murders killed Jim, too.
They could have, Tano. But for some reason, they wanted Jim to be found here alive. He's coming, too. Help me carry him to the porch.
So that's why I'm after Cavendish, Jim. The reason for the mask. My real identity is to be kept a secret. Known only to the three of us.
Well, I'll be hanged. You sure got a job cut out for yourself, Reed. I mean, Lone Ranger. I'll help him any way I can.
I was hoping you'd join us, Jim, and live up at our old silver mine.
Oh, you're mighty kind to an old ex-ranger who used to nurse me, you boy. Sure would like to. Never did like living here trying to farm, only...
Only what?
Well, I can't run out now with the owner of the bank. Poor old Judge Knox lying dead back there. Folks might think that I did it. Why, they might start blaming me for all the rest of the killings that's going on in town.
More murders, Jim?
Yes, lots of them. First, it was Lem Peters. He owns a newspaper. Then Biff Anderson, postmaster and telegraph man combined. Then Max Strauss, the hotel man. And a couple others, too. Why, it seems everybody important in Colby is getting shot. The sheriff's plumb going crazy.
Did you recognize the man who killed the judge?
Couldn't mistake him. It was Butch Cavendish, the owl hoot you said you're after.
Cavendish? He must be doing these killings in Colby for a very special reason.
Yeah, but why?
Most likely he wanted the murders to look like a local affair. I'm certain Jim will upset his plans if you're not around to accept the blame for the judge's death. That old silver mine of ours will be a perfect hideout for you.
Yes, it would. By cranky, I guess you're right. It would be best if I became scarce around here for a bit. I'll go along with you.
That's fine. How's his knee, Tonto?
Leg better now.
Good. Help me put Jim on Silver's back.
A few hours later, after a tedious ride over winding trails and unknown paths, the Lone Ranger, Jim, and Tonto approached the site of the secret silver mine.
Now, this is it, Tonto.
Where am I?
Don't see it, do you, Jim? Fooled you just like everybody else.
Come on, I'll show you. Here we are, Tonto. It must have been 10 years ago that my brother, old Jim here, and I discovered the mine and built this shack.
9 years ago this spring.
Still no see mine.
Over here, Tonto. It's under the bunk. There.
Yep, one of the richest veins of silver ever found in these here parts.
I never thought I'd care about digging up the ore. That is, until now.
Water there, too.
That's a spring we were cleaning out when we found the vein. We drained the water to get to the silver ore. Jim, you and I can fix up this place while Tana goes into town for the sheriff. His name is Taylor, isn't it?
Yep, old two-gun is still on the job.
All right, Kimosabe.
When you find the sheriff, tell him you know where Jim Blaine is. He'll come with you.
That's good. Me go now.
Jack seems to be in pretty good shape.
I'll be as snug as a bug.
All I want out of this place is enough silver for some immediate needs. Other than that, all you can dig is yours.
Oh, now I couldn't.
You're entitled to it, Jim. You'll have to do all the work.
You know, I could refine a little ore right here.
That's just what I want you to do, Jim. Then in the future, whenever Tonto and I come back here, we can get the pure metal for money and bullets.
Bullets?
Yes. I want some of the ore cast into silver bullets.
Thunderation, what's the matter with lead bullets? They'll kill just as well as...
You forget, I told you I vowed never to shoot to kill. Silver bullets will serve as sort of a symbol. Tonto suggested the idea.
Symbol? Of what?
A symbol which means justice by law. I want it to become known to all who see the silver bullets that I live and fight only to see the eventual defeat and the proper punishment by law of every criminal in the West.
By criminy, I think you've got something there. And I'll mold you all the silver bullets you want, Ranger. But from what I know about this here country, there'll be an awful lot of silver shot up before you're through.
I hope not, Jim. We have a lot of metal here for that purpose. If we need it.
Now, those dirty killers. I wish I knew where to look for them first. Now, Pete, you look up in that old creek section for Jim. Lem, go get Creel and fetch the doc's body and bring it back into town. This is a fine time for Doc Drummond to be missing. Jim Blaine disappearing. I never suspected he'd ever have anything to do with these killings.
Sheriff.
Well, go away, Indian. Can't see I'm busy. Now, Bill Keefe says that Jim's horse is still at his farm. Oh, he must have gone off on foot. Now, he can't be very...
Sheriff. Hard. Me know where Jim Blaine is.
Look, Indian, will you go away, please? Can't you see I'm busy with these men? What'd you say?
Me know where Jim Blaine is. Him want to see you.
Well, you know where he is. Why didn't you say so? Where is he?
Me not tell.
What do you mean by that? You just said you knew.
You come. Me take you to Jim.
Now, wait a minute. How do I know that you know where Jim is?
You don't know, but you follow me. Jim wants to talk to you about Judge Knox's killing.
Bet he does, all right. Yeah, and I want to talk to him, too. Hank, you and I are saddled up. We're going to follow this engine.
No one come. Only you.
Now, look. You don't think I'd be silly enough to go with you alone, do you?
Me think so. You brave lawman want to solve mysteries.
If you're right. Well, maybe he's right, huh? How long a ride is it?
Not far for a tough sheriff. Maybe 2 hours away.
All right, Injun. You lead the way. But don't forget, any funny business? Hank, keep an eye on things while I come back.
All right, two guns.
Just a minute, stranger.
Down the gun, Sheriff. I can explain.
Howdy, two guns!
Jim, what the Sam Hill's going on here?
Who are these people? Who's this masked man? What about Judge Knox shooting? Somebody's got a heap of explaining to do.
And after the killers knocked me out and changed guns with me, my friend and his engine pal brought me here.
It's a very interesting story, Jim. What's more interesting, maybe, is that you've convinced me the masked man here is fighting on the right side of the law.
I'm glad you're convinced, Sheriff.
So Butch Cavendish is the judge's murderer, huh?
Yep. And right now he's somewhere in this here vicinity, wounded, with my bullet in him.
Wounded, huh? Say, maybe that explains something. Old Doc Drummond's the only doc in these parts, and he's missing.
10-1 he's been fetched to fix up Cavendish.
Yeah, problem now is, where's Cavendish hiding out?
He left a trail leading away from Jim's farm. I think I might be able to follow it, Sheriff.
Good. I'll get some men from town.
That'll take too much time. It would be quicker for you to come with me now. Tonto can ride to town.
Me do, then follow your trail.
All right, Injun. See my man Creel at the office. Mm. He'll get some men.
Watch it late, Jim.
Look here.
Wagon tracks.
Cavendish was followed by someone in a wagon, and a horseman riding alongside of it.
Those tracks were made by Doc Drummond's rig. He's got the only narrow rims around here.
So far, so good. Let's go.
Take it easy.
Well, I'm doing the best I can. That's it.
All right, get on with the bandaging. I'm in a hurry.
What's the matter? You scared of something? Like maybe the sheriff will find us?
Why should I be? I'm getting rid of him just like I did everybody else of importance in Colby.
You mean to say that you're responsible for all those murders that have happened in the last week?
Sure. Might as well let you know. You see, Doc, all the men that have stepped into their vacated positions belong to my organization. It's taken a lot of planning, but we're just about set. I'm taking over Colby.
Well, why are you telling me this?
I'm going to be needing sawbones in my organization, and I've just decided you're going to be him.
Like blazes I am. I'd die before I'd help a pack of coyotes like...
What was that?
Doggone nag. I think they heard us.
Somebody over there. Give me that gun. I'll cover the dock. You boys get over there and find out.
Here they come. Take cover.
Whatever's going on out there, my man will take care of it.
Partner. Watch these men, Sheriff. I'll go help the doc.
Jerry! Pike! What's going on? Answer!
You go take a look. I want to find out what's happening. But don't run. I've got this on your back.
Cavendish, drop that gun. All right, Sheriff, bring in the others.
You all right, Doc?
Yeah, I'm all right. Who's the masked man?
He's on the side of the law.
Well, this crook was going to take over Colby. He admitted all those murders.
We know, Doc. We overheard him. Sheriff, you can take Cavendish to town in Doc's buggy. These other three will tie up and put on their horses. Doc, do you know where their mounts are?
Yes, behind the rocks over yonder.
Thanks.
Here you are, Doc. Watch these owl hoots close while I tie them up.
Yeah. I hope they do make a move, especially this one.
Remember this, boys. I'm not in jail yet.
Shut up. Working your mouth is making a move.
Come on, Silver. Silver. What's wrong, Silver?
Those are my men. I knew they were due here about this time. So you thought you had me, Sheriff. Well, you have. You, the sawbones, and that masked man over there behind those rocks can start counting the minutes you got to live. Beginning right now.
Silver.
Something's happened to the boss.
Boys, I got him. Get him high, Sheriff. Come on in, men. It's me, Cavendish. The shooting's over.
Looks like we got here just in time, boss.
You did.
Tie these men up.
What goes on?
I got winged after I shot Judge Knox. The sawbones there was treating me when the sheriff and the masked man took things over.
Is that the hombre we seen ride off on the white horse?
Yeah, which way did he go?
Up the draw.
They're all tied up, boss.
Good. I'll watch him. You men get after that masked man before he gets to Colby and spoils our plans, and bring him back dead or alive.
You heard it, boys. Let's travel.
Meanwhile, unaware of what has happened to the Lone Ranger since last he saw him, Tonto has arrived in the town of Colby. He's on his way to the sheriff's office to ask the sheriff's assistant, Alex Creel, for more men to aid the Lone Ranger in tracking down Butch Cavendish.
The way you keep on cleaning that gun, Corey, you must be figuring on using it soon.
Nothing like being prepared. Might a lot's been going on around Colby lately, and the shooting's only just begun. Creel says there's going to be more of it tonight.
Which one of you is sheriff's assistant?
It isn't often a redskin comes looking for the sheriff. It's usually the other way around.
What do you want, Indian?
Me want to see Creel.
At present, he's busy. I'm handling his business. What's on your mind?
Sheriff Taylor sent me. Him on trail of Butch Cavendish. Asked for Creel to come with posse.
Oh, he did, huh? You're lying, Indian. Everybody around here knows that Cavendish gang is nowhere around here.
That's not so. I see Cavendish myself. You come. I show you trail.
Will you listen to the redskin ordering us around? I don't know what your game is, Indian, but if Sheriff Taylor really sent you, you'd have some kind of proof.
You follow Tonto. You have plenty proof.
Seems to me this redskin's getting a little ornery, Corey. Should I throw him in jail?
No, let him go. Don't come nosing around here again, or you won't get off so easy. Creel left orders not to lead a posse anywhere.
Say, Corey, do you think he was on the level about the sheriff being on Cavendish's trail?
Of course he was on the level. Why do you think I signed to protect Cavendish? With all of our plans set for tonight, we can't let the sheriff mess things up.
But if that engine gets back to the sheriff and tells him that Creel...
He's not going to get back to the sheriff, because you're going to see that he doesn't. Savvy?
Yeah, I savvy. You got nothing to worry about. Nothing like making sure, Engine.
Tonto, Silver. Tonto.
Me follow trail, Kemosabe. Take long time.
Where's the posse?
No posse. Sheriff's men in Colby wouldn't send men with me.
He must be one of Cavendish's men.
That's right. Him send man to ambush me. Let me take care of him. You find Cavendish?
Yes. But his men rode down from the hills and surrounded the sheriff and Doc Drummond.
We go back and round them up?
No, there are too many of them. We'd need a whole troop of cavalry to capture them all. And I've got a plan, Tonto. Now, here's the idea. We'll circle back. Cavendish's horse. He must still be here. The rest of his men are out looking for me.
Where are Doc and Sheriff?
Over in the glen behind the brush. Come on, Tonto. Still must be here with the doc. I imagine that Cavendish is watching our friends until his men return. We'll sneak up to the glen. If Cavendish is there, I'll want to surprise him. Then you know what to do. A hoot owl.
Me understand.
We'll leave our horses here.
Take it easy, you two. I may not be strong enough to travel, but I got strength enough to pull a trigger.
You won't get away with this. How long do you think honest people are going to condone activities like yours, Cavendish? You know I've got men in my office who've sworn never to rest until you're captured. Myself included, of course. And that masked man, he's one of my special secret deputies. Your men will never catch him.
You know, Cavendish, the doc here and I and the masked man, we know a lot more about you than you think we do. Why, there's handbills on you all over this territory, pasted on every rock and every tree. You'll never get out of here. And another thing.
Woo-hoo!
Attaboy, stranger. You're a sight for sore eyes.
Yeah. I thought we were goners. Who's the Indian?
He's my friend. Are you both all right?
Yeah, we're all right.
Yeah.
Cavendish is out cold.
Where you been, stranger? I was getting worried.
I rode off on Silver. Met Tonto coming from Colby. We sneaked in here the back way. Sheriff, your man Creel in town wouldn't send the posse.
Him no believe Tonto.
Well, then that proves he's part of this murdering fiend's band. And I can name more in town that are working with him. Well, anyway, we got Cavendish. We can load him in Doc's rig and take him on into town.
Wait a minute, Sheriff. I want to capture more of the gang than just Cavendish.
He's the leader.
With help, we can capture him and his entire band when they return.
Take too long to get help from Colby. They'll all get away.
There's help much closer than town, Sheriff. Tonto said he saw a cavalry detachment passing a short distance off. We'll get their help. I'll leave Cavendish here. He's out and too weak to travel anyway.
Well, whatever you say.
All right, let's go. Come on, Doc.
Don't worry, you're not going to lose me.
Which way to the cavalry, mister?
Take the right fork and circle back to Colby.
To Colby? What about the cavalry?
There are no cavalry.
Thought you said they're passing through hereabouts.
What I said was for Cavendish to hear.
But he couldn't hear anything. He was unconscious.
You should have examined him when I did, Doc. He was faking.
Well, if there's no cavalry, just what in tarnation are you aiming to do?
I'm trying to delay Cavendish's plans, Sheriff, to gain time. We have a lot to do tonight in Colby.
All right, Doc, let's get on with it.
All right.
Some of these men spotted the masked man, Chief, at the cinch he didn't head for Colby.
I know he didn't.
Say, what happened to the prisoners?
Masked man must have hidden the brush nearby. While you were out straining the eyes for him, he come back here with an engine friend.
Turned the prisoners loose, huh?
Yeah. They all let out fast, but not for Colby. They went the opposite direction.
Where'd they go?
I overheard the masked man tell the sheriff there's a group of cavalry passing nearby. Now, they've gone off to get him to round us all up, so we got to work fast. Green, you, Sellers, and Shep stick here with me. We'll go back to the hideout. The rest of you try to head off the prisoners. See if you can spot that cavalry, too. This is going to delay my plans concerning Colby a bit. I can't take any chances. Now get stirring.
I sure hope Cleo didn't see us come in here. The sheriff's office is practically next door to mine, and I noticed the lights were still on.
That's all for the good, Doc. It will give Tonto a chance to sneak over there and see if anyone else is in the office with Creel. While he's gone, we can make up that list of the names of the people we want to surprise.
Me go now, Kemosabe.
Be careful, Tonto. Remember, Creel is one of Cavendish's men. You know what happened the last time you tried to see him.
Me be plenty careful. You make list ready. Tonto be back fast.
Are we sure that we hid your horses and my wagon far enough out of town? If anybody gets wind we're here, there'll be trouble.
If we act fast enough, nobody will have time to stop us. All right, Sheriff. Write down the names of the new men in town. The ones who've been taking over all the top jobs.
Well, first of all, is Creel, of course.
Put his name at the head of the list. If we take the jail first, we'll have a place to lock up all the others.
And then there's Keeler. He took over the bank as soon as the judge was murdered.
Keeler. Yes, old Jim told me about him.
Yeah, and what about Ence? He was put in charge of the telegraph office mighty sudden.
Ence, I've heard of him, too.
Then there's Jessup. He's that new gunsmith. And Peters, Dude, and Corey.
Well, Tonto, what did you find out?
Me take peek through window of sheriff's office. See Creel in there with one man.
Just two of them, eh? All right, Sheriff, Doc, we'll start with Creel and his friend. And if everything goes well, we'll end up with the whole Cavendish gang.
All right, come on, boys.
I wonder what's keeping Cavendish.
Sure getting to be late enough.
Oh, I don't know, Creel. Maybe him and the boys were held up. Probably he didn't send us a message or something.
Who is it?
It's me, Doc Drummond. An emergency.
Doc, I thought you was out of town, Chief.
Quiet, you two. Keep your hands high.
Say, what's going on here?
Plenty, Creel. Tonto, get Red's gun.
We have reasons to believe you two are working for Butch Cavendish.
And I've got an idea. Those credentials you showed me to get your job were forged.
Now, wait a minute. You can't prove
it. Shut up. Get in that cell. You two, Red.
Two gun, give me that list you made of Creel's pals.
Betcha. All right.
All right, Doc. We've got to hurry. It's getting light outside. Come on, Tonto.
Are you running the bank now in place of Judge Knox?
Yeah, but what's that got to do with
it? Well, take a gander. The place is on fire.
Fire?
All right, Keeler. March.
Huh?
Keeler, check. One down and seven to go. Are you the gent that took over the telegraph office when Biff Anderson got his?
What about it, Doc?
Well, come on quick. Your place is on fire.
What?
Put your hands up, Rivers.
Fire?
On your way, Jessup.
trace of the masked man and his friends, huh?
No, we spent the whole night looking.
What about the cavalry?
Must have gone through here awful fast, Chief. Nary a sign of them now.
Good. Then there's nothing to stop us from moving into Colby right now.
Right.
Let's go.
All right, men. You heard the masked man. Everything goes as we figured. We'll have the Cavendish gang locked up by sundown.
Hanu, are your men all set?
Yes, Kemosabe.
Here they come!
All right, boys. Let's go get them.
Run, Stuart!
Man's leading them.
We can take them. We outnumber them.
Let them have it, men. Got me, stranger.
Drop your gun, Cavendish. It's been a long chase. Now you're through for good.
I guess you're right.
All right, let's go.
Where to?
Back to the fight.
Where'd you say?
I said. Now get going.
Name.
Put him in one.
I sure am glad to see them.
Name.
Shorty Bush.
Finally got you, huh? Put him in two.
Let's go.
I'm going.
Name.
Dick Lambert.
One.
Okay.
And I want to tell you that the whole town of Colby is proud of you, Two Gun.
Well, I appreciate that a lot, Jim, but we had very little...
Jim, come now, Sheriff.
Here he is, Sheriff.
Hello, Cavendish. Didn't think you'd catch him, partner. Now we got the whole dang bunch.
You and your men are to be congratulated, Sheriff.
Thanks. But if it hadn't been for you, we'd have gotten nowhere. I'll be with you in just a minute.
I'll take care of this one personally. Come on.
Easy, Silver.
Now, Cavendish can't catch it, Kimasabi. You take off mask.
I'm going to continue to wear the mask and keep my identity a secret.
For how long?
Our job has just begun. We have a lot of trails to follow.
That good.
Sheriff, before the lockup, do you mind telling me who the masked man is?
Wouldn't mind at all, except that... Hey, where'd the masked man go?
He and his Indian pal are going out to get the horses, Sheriff.
Well, guess he isn't going to stick around for a party.
Well, who is he?
I don't rightly know his real name, but I've heard him called the Lone Ranger.
Get him, Sheriff!